In Alexander's journey, we begin to come up against the limitations of the warrior archetype, and it becomes impossible to ignore them anymore. The virtue of aggression becomes just outright conquest and oppression. The desire for supremacy becomes the subjugation of the innocent. And we start to ask ourselves, is conquest a good thing? I mean, what is that all about? And even the Spartans, if we go back to them, who we admired so much for their virtue at the Battle of Thermopylae, once they, after their victory over Athens in the Peloponnesian War, when they were removed from the sequestered environment of Sparta, their virtue just evaporated. They now became kind of colonels and generals in charge of the cities around the Aegean Sea, and they were removed from the atmosphere of virtue in Sparta. And they began to become guilty of bribery, of oppression, of stealing. And what happened was that they had been raised in this kind of sequestered environment of virtue. And once they were out of it, they were uninoculated against the evils of the world, and they just kind of fell prey to them. And we have a number of letters of Spartan mothers from back home in Sparta, sending letters to their sons who were colonels and generals overseas, saying something like, quit your thieving or quit breathing. And in fact, the great Spartan commander Lysander, who's presided over the conquest of Athens, he used to brag that he cheated boys with knuckle bones and men with lies. And after his victory over Athens at Aegos Potami, he ordered the right hands of every Athenian sailor cut off so they could never row again. And when Sparta took the surrender of the city of Plataea, which had been its great ally in 479, not that long ago, they marched the captured defenders in front of a table, and each one was asked one question: what service have you performed for Sparta? And if they had no answer, they were put to death right on the spot. In other words, the warrior mindset, for all its virtues, and there are virtues, seems to be no guarantee of honorable behavior in and of itself. And in fact, Alexander himself, as we said, fell prey to this, 100 years later. So we have to ask ourselves, what does it mean to win? Is winning everything? What is conquest? Is conquest some great thing? Why is that a good to the people who are conquered? And the worst part of it is that this warrior mindset gone wrong seems to destroy not only others, but the warrior himself. And in fact, Alexander, towards the end of his life, got to such a kind of mental state that he used to stay up all night long, sacrificing to the god fear. It seems that virtue is not necessarily an aspect of the warrior mindset.